n from 0 to 2 prime d phi prime, and then from 0 to 1 and d of cos theta prime, and this will be plus v, means plus v not addition with this one, but plus v is the potential, and x square plus a square minus 2ax cos of theta prime, and this is 3 over 2. And you will enclose this in a bracket. This was our point, our solution in the integral form when we have not limited our observation point on the z-axis only. And now we will have to simplify this one a little bit. So phi of x is equal to a x squared minus a squared over 4 pi, and then this is integral minus v I take out of the integral from 0 to 2 pi d phi prime, and then integral from minus 1 to 0 and d cos theta prime. And this one, if I take x squared is common, then x squared 2 will cancel and I will get x cubed here, and that x cubed I move up, so it will become x minus 3. And this one, 1 plus a square over x square minus 2 a over x cos of theta prime, and minus 3 over 2. Right? I have just moved it up. And then, okay, one thing we will have to correct here. This one is not cos theta prime, this is cos gamma. Cos gamma becomes equal to cos theta prime when you are the z-axis. So we will have to correct here and here. This is cos gamma. Similarly, this one will be cos gamma. Right? Plus, and now this one I am not writing, but it is understood what is this one. Because what it will be? It will be plus v 0 to 2 pi d pi prime d cos theta prime x minus 3 1, all this, only this will be plus v. The only difference between the two is this one. Integral limits will be different. So it is symmetric, so I am not writing this one. And now we will focus on something, this one, a over x, or we say that we will expand this one, and we will look to the a over x, because I know that when I expand this function in a series, there will be different terms in it. Then the series is supposed to be trimmed at some point. What will be my, you can say the way to go will be to focus on a over x. A is fixed, while x is my observation point. How much far I am from the hemispheres? So x equal to 1a will be the surface, x equal to 2a will be, let's say, this point, x over a, like a over x means third point, and so on. So it seems that the series will be converging. As I will go away from this one, a over x will grow, and a over x will be converging to 0, right? So the higher terms I will neglect them. When I will go very far from here, then I will not observe this geometry as geometry of two hemispheres. It will change. So I will have to now focus on this one only, and let's see that what will be the situation with this one. What about 1 plus a square over x square minus 2a over x and cos of gamma and minus 3 over 2. So I will have no focus on this one. Now you know how to expand this one? Binomial series.
Yes.
Right? So this will be, this thing is equal. This is equal to, means you know that 1 plus nx raised to the power, 1 plus x raised to the power n, and this you can approximate 1 plus nx plus n other terms, right? So the series we will utilize that series, and what will be the first term in this one? It will be 1. Minus, it will be the power which is 3 by 2, and then this whole thing which is out of 1. So minus 3 by 2 and a square over x square minus 2a over x and cos of gamma, right? Plus, this will be 1 over 2 factorial will be first, because the next term. Then the power which is minus 3 over 2, and then you will have minus 3 by 2 minus 1. You know the formula. So it will become minus 5 by 2. And then the x term, which is this one, a square over x square minus 2a over x and cos of gamma. And this will have power equal to 2, because this is x, and now 1 over 2 factorial, and n is n minus 1 divided by n minus 1 into x square. So the x square is equal to this, and plus 1 over 3 factorial, then minus 3 over 2, then minus 5 over 2, and then again 1 minus 1. So it will become minus 7 over 2, because minus 3 by 2 minus 2 n minus 1 n minus 2. So it will become minus 7 over 2. And this one, a square over x square minus 2a over x and cos gamma, and it will have its power equal to 3, right? Okay. And plus there are more terms. So I can simplify this, and this is equal to 1 plus, just multiply them. The very first I will take this power. 3 over 2 into 2a over x cos gamma. Because here is cos gamma, here is cos gamma squared and cube and so on. Yes. So I will write this one is 3, because 2 will cancel, and this will become 3a over x and cos of gamma. And then the next term will be plus a over x whole squared, and then I will just, you can say, simplify this, minus 3 over 2 plus 15 over 2 and cos squared gamma plus a over x whole cube and minus 15 over 2 cos gamma plus 35 over 2 cos q gamma and plus some more terms. So what I did, I just simplified this one. Now if you multiply with this one, this will become minus 3 over 2 a square over x square. So I have moved it here. Minus 3 over 2 a square over x square. What I am doing, I am just following this tactic, that then I will approximate with a over x. A over x is telling me how much far I am going from this hemisphere's geometry. So all this you can write in a compact form like this one. You can do few steps, and what you will get after this one, this is for 1 plus this minus 3 by 2 is other in here. So I did it for this. Then this one will also have that situation. But you know that one is plus V and the other is minus V. You take V common. Then one is plus, the other is minus. So it means this one will have also such a series. And there is subtraction as well. Right? There is subtraction as well. So you know, you are subtracting from one integral, means which will be the positive hemisphere, the other integral which will be due to the negative hemisphere, because these two are being added here. So you will do this addition, this one is with minus and this one with plus. So between two hemispheres you are doing the subtractions. So some of the terms, they will come common, they will cancel. And this I will say that, let me write the comment as well. We will end up subtracting integrals over top and bottom hemispheres. Hemispheres, and only when you will do this on practice, calculate for the other one as well, do their subtraction, then you will come to know that only R's of cos gamma will survive. The even powers will cancel. So only the R power of this will survive. So what is the first? The first term that will survive here will be cos gamma, then cos cube gamma, and then cos 5 gamma, and so on. They will survive. While rest of the terms will give you 0. They will add up to 0. So we are left only with this. You know, we have only solved this portion. Yet we will have to integrate this one. When you will integrate the very first term here, then it will be some solution. But come to cos gamma, you will have to integrate cos gamma. Then you will integrate cos cube gamma and cos 5 gamma and so on. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So we will now start with this, that our integral is up to this, and we have come to the conclusion that only the R powers of cos gamma will survive. And now we will see what cos gamma integral will give, what cos cube integral will give. This one we will not do, but we will do some approximations for the higher terms. only the first two we will capture in order to get some idea. So this will also tell you that why at Griffiths level you are only on the line. You are not going here and there from this line. Okay? Okay. So the very first one, I'm going for cos gamma. So it will be integral from 0 to 2 pi d phi prime, and integral from 0 to, or means don't put the limits, because we will solve generally. Because cos gamma will come for this one, as well as cos gamma will come for this one as well. So just write the integral, and d cos of theta prime and cos of gamma. So this is equal to integral d phi prime and integral d cos theta prime, and now put the value of cos gamma. You remember the value of cos gamma. Cos gamma is equal to sine theta prime cos phi minus phi prime, and plus cos theta prime. This is the value of cos gamma. This is the value of cos gamma. So we will have to do a little bit of more algebra here, and that algebra will be, this one is then equal to d phi prime and d of cos theta prime, and then I can write for this one, you see, sin theta is here a constant. Sin theta prime is a variable, because we are integrating on cos theta prime. So this one is just a constant and this is a variable. While this one, so sin theta prime and cos phi minus phi prime, they are odd even functions, right? And you know that odd even function always give you zero. So this one is gone, only this one will remain. So I can write that this is cos theta and cos theta.